Or at least I know exactly what the next orb I'm gonna go after is. Like how she's still out here, not when she's like in her pajamas or whatever, her nightgown. Oh, you need a plus one version or better? Oh my god. Greedy little biatch. No, I'm just gonna go try and reforge it. Game seems pretty stable at the moment. Give that to, though. Wait, who? Is she the only one that can wear it? She is. Done. I love it. 3 MP restored each turn. Thank you very much. I know, but things may get a little unstable here, so we are going to save just in case, though. No, Krim. I'm not already. I don't already have 26 hours in. I'm only 26 hours in. I believe is what you mean. This is a Dragon Quest game we're talking about here. Of the main story, I am about a fifth of the way through. About 23% of the way through the game. I mean, it may go a little faster because it's my second playthrough. Well, I was just thinking, because it took me 110 hours to beat the game the first time. And I'm at 26 right now. Yeah, 110 to complete the main story. Oh god. Yeah, 110 to complete the main story. Well, about 110. And I didn't actually complete all the post-game, so there is that. Oh god, what just happened there? Oh god, what just happened there? I don't know what happened. Things just kind of went awry. Oh. Oh well. I think we're going to have a cooldown on the things. We're going to have to wait 5 minutes before we can try to craft that again, which means we'll have time to go and pick up another quest. I know, man. What a crash. This game's so unstable. It's like borderline Shenmue here. It's also, it's 27 hours and 26 and 27 minutes, by the way, Graham, not 26. Shorten me an hour and almost an hour and 30 minutes there. God. Let's see if it lets me craft immediately. It does. Oh, nope, it doesn't. Okay, we gotta wait 5 minutes. Fine then. Magic. Teleport. Go to Honolulu. So you can actually make this game, this part of the game, pretty hard for yourself if you don't talk to the queen. Because if you talk to her, she'll give you pretty big hints on where to go. But if you don't talk to her, obviously, then you don't get those hints. And you have to try and figure it out yourself. In my case, I already know where to go. You're gonna make me sail all the way up north just to find your stupid little thing. Well, fine. I have to burn some time anyways. I don't know. I'll have to check out the trophies later, just to see how close I may be able to get without trying very hard, and then see from there whether I want to go after Platinum or not. Like, if there's anything super annoying, I'm not doing it.
We win again.
I am, though, thinking of closer to the release of Shenmue 3, replaying the Shenmue 1 and 2 again, and actually playing them with the intent to, like, get the platinum on both of them. Whether I'll end up doing it or not, I don't know, but it's something I've been toying around with in my mind that might be fun to do. I definitely have to follow a strict guide, though, to do it. It'll probably get delayed. Let's be serious here. There's a very low chance that it's actually coming out next August. Which sucks, because I do really want to play it. I was watching something about him. I guess he was got interviewed, and he was talking about how the, well, it had been, like 16 years or something since the game first released, like Shenmue 2 and whatnot. But for, for the in-game time, it'll be, like, it'll pick up at, like, the next day, basically. Like, the day after Shenmue 2 ended is when the game will actually pick up.
Ha!
Oh yeah, and that was definitely a monster we fought that was previously a boss. Oh yeah, one of the reasons like I never really beat a lot of the older Dragon Quest games is because they did that shit where not everybody gets XP. And I really just don't have time for that. So nowadays, if I play a game where not every, like an RPG where not everybody gets XP in the party, I get very annoyed with it. It was one of my few complaints about Octopath Traveler. Like I don't have very many complaints about Octopath Traveler, but one of the ones I do have is that your reserve party members don't get XP in that game.
Score one for the good guy. Fabulous, darling.
It's especially an Octopath since it encourages you switching up your party so much. It's really annoying. It's what basically why I ended up sticking to three party members and just switching out the last one every single time. Ended up biting me in the ass though when I got around to doing the post game dungeon. It's why I still haven't finished the post game dungeon on stream. It's because I'm currently still in the process of leveling all the characters up to at least level 75 or higher. Oh, did you see the thing on, I think Silicon Era posted it? They posted a, I guess Famitsu did a, I don't know, they did like a questionnaire for both the, you know, foreign and Japanese audiences comparing all the stuff about Octopath Traveler, like what characters people liked or what characters people picked as their first character and, you know, what stories they found the best and all that stuff. I thought it was pretty interesting to see the differences between what Japan and what basically everyone else thought. It's pretty cool. One of the things they said was like, what was their favorite aspect of the game? And it's pretty funny because the overwhelmingly highest selection for Japanese audiences of their favorite part about the game was that they really liked the art style, the dot art, right? However, say they overwhelmingly liked the dot art, and then after that it was like other stuff. Whereas the US or the Western audiences overwhelmingly liked the battle system as the main thing. I mean, it makes sense when you look at the current market of the Japanese video game industry. It's all cell phone games where the substance of the game is very light, but there's a lot of emphasis placed on the art. This was the island. This is the most northern island here. Unless it's talking about the one that's inland. I guess it must be talking about the inland one. Yeah, my favorite part about Octopath Traveler was probably the battle system, followed by the music. And then actually liked the story. Not that it was like super great or anything, like wasn't anything groundbreaking, but it was good enough that it was a driving factor to me. Then after that would probably be the art. I just don't think I could ever think that the art is the main thing I like about a video game. That just seems like something really hard for me to picture, where that's the part that like I like the most.
Another one bites the dust.
Yeah, I mean, I see art and like even music. Like I really like the music in Octopath Traveler, and it's one of my favorite parts of it. But I don't think I would ever see music as my favorite part of a game. I mean, unless it's like a music-based game, of course, that would be a little bit different. But I see things like art and music as stuff that complements the rest of the game. And, you know, art and music, to an extent, can make up for some shortcomings, especially music. Music can definitely make up for some shortcomings. Yeah, I love the art direction of Persona 5, but I wouldn't call that my favorite aspect of the game, right? Because, like, just the music alone would not make that my favorite game. It's a sum of its parts. I love everything else about it. Where is this damn... I always hit this party talk.
You good?
I don't even care about it. Oh man, I'm looking this up. I don't really feel like wandering around forever. Dragon. Really? It's that one? That's not even really north of it. Apparently it's on Slime Island, which isn't even north, it's like northeast of it. But okay. We get to take a visit to Slime Island. I don't know, I think those little pep voices where they go in the pep and they're like, ah, I think those are unnecessary. They seem a little... They feel forced. I think the voice actor feels like it's like they're forcing themselves. Almost all of them.
Wonderful.
Found it. That just seems so not that good. So I can lose 6 defense and 5 charm, and I gain what, 3 magical might, magical mending, and 1% increase crits and spells? That just seems so just bad. Like, how is that good? That costs 6. Thank you. Go ahead and grab her magical might. I really need to figure out what I want to do with him now that I've got Hustle Dance. Nice. Got that. Okay, so he's, I think, done. Over on this side. Of course, that's really good. Just an extra 20% magical mending. But I do really want to try this out over here. Giving him claws. Okay, I think I'm gonna go ahead and call the stream here tonight. It's about 3 a.m. Kinda wanna try and actually get to sleep on at a decent time tonight. So we have three more orbs to get. I know where they all are. So starting tomorrow, we will go and grab those three orbs. Well, we'll grab one of them pretty quickly. The other two are kinda more involved. So we're gonna get the early one. Mainly because the other one allows me to complete one of the quests we have left. And we'll see how things go from there, how far we get.